What's up, guys? Welcome to the 847 Club. We're going to hit you guys up with a Kanye West track review.
You said Kanye West.
Featuring Cactus Jack, Travis, Scott, and Zell.
We like Fortnite! We like Fortnite!
He was supposed to drop this video a day ago.
Well, hold on. Whoever's breathing on the mic, you better fucking stop.
I don't know.
Joey, did you hear it?
I didn't hear it. Maybe it is me. I don't know.
Well, look, do you see my mic? Do you see where it is?
We got some first-time listeners in here. We're going to give you guys a reaction and review.
What are we supposed to do?
All right. Before we start this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you get notified when we post videos.
Yeah, ring. Yeah. Do that. Girls. So, have you guys listened to this yet?
Yes. Only one
I
time.
I haven't watched the video.
You guys are fucking disgusting.
I haven't watched the video either.
What the fuck is wrong with you guys? Oh my god.
Have you guys seen it?
These are fucking filthy. Alright, so Gina, you said you have. Matthew has not. Jovi has once. And Tristan did. So me and Matt are the first time listeners.
Nice, yes, sir.
Nice. This is the first time watching the video, though. For me.
How do y'all feel about the song?
I like it. It's fire. I won't lie.
Oh, Tristezy, how do you feel about it?
I didn't know who was on the track, and then all of a sudden I heard Travis Scott, and I was like...
For a...
Yeah, hit a good 5-second
verse. For another Jesus record, this slaps a little bit.
My crew is big and it keeps getting bigger. That's because Jesus Christ is my nigga.
I will say this. This song alone is better than the entire Jesus King album.
And I'll say this, Joey. Suck a good dick.
Bro, the Wiggles release better tracks than the entirety of Jesus King.
All right, name them. Name them.
Yummy, 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 yummy fruits.
I did my time and I want out.
This track was produced by Dr. Dre and... So is, I think, some of his next album. I know Dr. Dre is producing. He's remixing Jesus is King. Like, all the songs that were in Jesus is King, Dr. Dre is remixing them.
Thank
and
God.
Mastering them. And
yeah. It was so bad he needed a new producer to edit it.
Yeah, so that's Jesus is King 2, but God's Country is, like, just his next.
God's Country.
Yeah, that's the name of the album that this is going to be on.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to be real with you, Chief. Like, if he doesn't drop this soon, I'm just going to stop listening to Kanye. Bro, I can't. Yeah, Jesus King's kind of bad.
It's hard being a Ye fan.
Drop this for the thugs. No, I grew up in a mud. The top is that enough. Wash us in the blood.
Is it anybody here? Is it anybody here?
Holy Spirit, come down. Holy Spirit, come down.
Come down.
Holy Spirit, help now.
Way down.
Holy Spirit, help now. Holy Spirit, come down. Holy Spirit, come down.
Execution 30 states. 30 states still execute. I should not kill, I should not spill. Next tales at the rendezvous. We got your time in the federal.
Whole life being thugs. No choice selling drugs. Genocide what it does. Slavery what it does.
Was that Grand Theft Auto?
I was about to say, I can't believe he whipped out, man, he whipped out the Elgato for this music video.
What the fuck?
That's why I kept laughing, because I was like, why is there GTA?
Yeah, I saw, I was like, did I see that right? Was that Grand Theft Auto?
Why?
I know why there was Grand Theft Auto.
Why was there Grand Theft Auto, Tristan?
He,
How video games are corrupting society?
No, because I don't think any of you guys listened to the Yandy album that leaked, but in one of the songs, he was relating how Grand Theft Auto, something about... Grand Theft Auto is just like a projection secretly that, you know, white people who play it don't know. That's like the actual projection of black life on the video game. So he's saying how, like, oh, something like we're living in a simulation, this and that, trying to compare it to playing the GTA game. And it goes along with the video, because the video to me is just like a bunch of clips about Black life, random here and there, and then what's going on in the world. And besides all those clips, the weird stuff that Ye was putting in the video that he made on the computer, it reminded me of watching the PS5 event. Like, <That's funny. laughs> it's like all the waves and stuff. I was like, what the heck? And him turning into Venom. Like,
yeah, what was up with that? Yeah. Yeah, I was like, there has to be some sort of symbolism behind like the thing appearing going onto his face. Like, I don't really understand that. Like, cause the whole thing is like, I'm taking this into like a religious context. So I imagine that's where Kanye is approaching it from, and like, so I imagine like being washed in the blood of Jesus would be a positive thing. But the whole video, as he's like screaming that, it's like, I don't know, he's being corrupted anyway, or he's being negatively affected. Unless, like, I don't know, his weird Venom armor is like a positive thing. I'm just not gonna taste my venom. I got that 100% on board, I guess, with the symbolism. I don't understand what's going on.
Well, I mean, like, the clips that he has of, like, the events that are going on in the world, it's pretty obvious that, like, the message he's trying to get across is, you know, we need Jesus, basically. I was really just confused on a lot of the animations of, like the waves and stuff like that in his face, like you guys are talking about. I don't really know what to make of that, but it's pretty obvious, like, and blatant that he's trying to put in, shed some more light on like what the events that are transpiring right now in America, which I think is cool that he's actually, you know, as cheesy as, you know, everyone's saying it, like, oh, these celebrities need to use their platform. I think he actually is using it as a way to show like what's going on, because he knows he has a huge audience, and I'm sure a lot of his audience is also like Caucasian, they're white. So, you know, the fact that he made this video showing like events that are going on, I think is really cool.
Especially after the, you know, the, what do you call it? The MAGA stuff. And then
it's going just into, confusing, like, a religious to space. Me. Yeah, it's confusing to me, like, where he stands on that at this point. Like, does he still support Trump? I don't know. But do I really care at this point? Because, like, he does seem to actually genuinely care about, like, you know, Black Lives Matter and the community. At least the African-American community. He does, you know, he's from Chicago. Like, he knows, he's lived it, so he knows it best. And it's just funny to see people criticize him, saying like he's not supporting or he's not helping these movements, but he really is, but he's just doing it in silence. Whereas like a lot of people are like, I don't know, posting about it. They're saying like, oh, this is how I helped. Whereas he, you know, what did he do? He like paid for George Floyd's daughter's like tuition or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
For when she goes to college, like, he didn't say anything about it, he just did it, you know. And he was walking with people in Chicago, he didn't post about it, he just did it, you know. And I think that sends a big message.
I think a lot of celebrities need to kind of follow that example. They're always like posting about it, like, oh, look what I did.
They're virtue signaling. They're virtue signaling.
Mm-hmm. When they should just do it because they want to do it, not because they're gonna get views and likes or whatever.
Yeah, I mean that's a fair point. Like, honestly, I feel like most celebrities, I'm not gonna, like, we're almost guilty of this too. Like, we'll do things that are positive, but then like, what optics matter, you know? But for Kanye, he I don't think he necessarily believes optics matter too much.
I mean, obviously, I know I like the song. It sounded fine, but yeah, the video. I was I figured I got like the message of like showing how like life, it seems probably like pretty different than some of his fan base probably has their life and like lives it, and it's just it's like cool. It's like cool to see him, like, how I think it was Joby saying it, like using his platform to like do it, like using his platform, but kind of like not doing it to just like boost his ego, just kind of doing it because he knows it's right, and to like help the community as opposed to just doing it just to do it for some likes or whatever. And I liked it a lot.
Early on in the Trump like era, like in this presidency, like you might look at like a Trump supporter and be like, you know, I disagree with your views. But at this point in the presidency, or at this point in 2020, it's really telling of a person, of what kind of person you are, if you really back that kind of person up. Right. And that's why I'm saying, like, I don't know where he stands at this point, but the fact that he hasn't really come out anymore and said like MAGA, 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 like, I think that maybe he has changed. Yeah. But like I said,
you go.
Oh, sorry. No, like I was saying, like I was reiterating, I don't really know if it matters at this point because his actions are speaking louder than his words, because he's actually doing the things that people, you know, preach about, like, you know, joining the movements, joining the crowds, going to the rallies. He's actually doing those things. And I think the actions are way more important than actually, you know, just talking.
What Jovi said was, like, I think it's really important in context, right, of like how we perceive Kanye West. Is like a MAGA hat is no longer like a political belief. It's like a character evaluation. Like, I don't like think about your political beliefs necessarily if I see you wearing a MAGA hat. I just think of you as a bad person pretty much immediately.
Yeah.
How do you guys feel about like the song itself?
Back to the music part of the song.
Tunes Tuesday.
It
beats banging.
It was pretty banging.
I hate you, Gina.
It was like, listening to it, it's got me curious as to what God's country is gonna sound like, because every Kanye album is a different sound, and this sound, it sounds like Yeezus. I think it's a Yeezus, like if you like just very throw it industrial. Any of the album, anywhere in the album, I think it you go over this song and then go to New Slaves, it sounds like it's supposed to be on the album, which is just like, I don't think that's really been done in any of his music. Try to pick out two albums that sound even remotely the same. It's like, I don't know, it's just weird as a Kanye fan listening to, you know, all of his albums all the time, for him to go back to a sound. And, you know, it's what people want. People be like, oh, go back to Graduation, go back to, you know, College Dropout, or do another Beautiful Twisted or something like that. And it's like, I don't know what, you know, it just has me curious. I don't know if he's going to release another single or how long it's going to be or anything like that. But to me, this track, it sounds like it's a mixture between a Yeezus song and a Life of Pablo song. Kind of sounds like Feedback a little bit.
I don't know. Cause like on one hand, yeah, like the background, like the production, it definitely sounds Yeezus. But I just don't feel like the vocal mix is necessarily Yeezus-y. It is up until the point where like the song is more of his real voice again, around when Travis Scott joins in, and then it sounds like
it was a little different digitally in the first half.
Yeah, the first half is digitally and very Yeezus-y, and then after that, it doesn't feel that way anymore. It just feels different. Well, Travis Scott's audition is so small; it's kind of hard to get it right where it is.
He's just like, yeah.
I don't know. The first Jesus is King, it was like mostly him and his choir. I think the only features on it were the Aunt Clemens, because he was on when he was making Yandy, Aunt Clemens was on like every song. And I feel like if that album dropped, he was going to blow up. But Aunt Clemens was on a few songs, and then it was the clips, but it was basically like himself. So I think this next album, he's going to try to get more of his friends like into the not explicit rap and like see what they can do on a rap Jesus record, I guess.
It's just so off-putting. It's so, I feel like a Jesus-based message is so antithetical.
Antithetical.
That's why I'm saying I don't know how much more music he's going to do if he says he's not going to do non-secular music ever again, which even when he said that at the listening party, he was like, I'm just going to be preaching God from now on. I'm like, this is not going to last. Like,
yeah. Like, nothing, commercially, it's not viable. Yeah. I don't think, like, imaginatively, it's too viable either. There's just only so many messages that you can do they're completely Jesus based.
Right.
I know. I was like, are you sure? Are you sure about that?
Maybe that's just me hoping he doesn't, because I just don't. I'm not a fan. I'm really not of that particular. What are you guys' final thoughts? We'll go Gina, Matt, Tris, and Joey.
Okay. I really like this song. I'm going to be bumping it on the way to work tomorrow for sure. Yeah, I like the beat, like how everything sounds and mixes. It's all good.
What about you, Matthew?
Yeah. I also like the song. When I was listening to it, I definitely felt like it was like part of Jesus almost. Like I could put it in there and didn't notice. But yeah, I like it a lot. It makes me actually kind of look forward to the album, if it's going to sound not like Jesus is King, because I definitely did not enjoy it. But I like this a lot, and yeah, I'm curious to see how the album's going to be.
Yeah. Is it?
I liked it. I gotta listen to it and like with the context of like the rest of the album, but for a standalone single, I thought it was pretty good. Good inclusion of Travis. I feel like if you throw Travis on any song, it's just like just add some vibes to it. But yeah. That's about it. That's all it did.
Jovis.
Very excited for the album if we get more of this stuff. What I appreciate about like his album releases is that you don't know what to expect. And people always want him to, like Tristan was saying, people always want him to go back to his old stuff. But I really appreciate that he refuses to go back to his old albums, and he just tries to innovate, tries to do new things, because that's who he is. And, you know, like Jesus is King, like, what is it, the Cudi, the Kids See Ghost. They're not always going to be perfect, but that's, you know,
except for Kids See Ghost.
When you're pioneering, when you're like venturing off into new things, like nothing's going to be perfect. And that's what I appreciate about it. That's why I always appreciate his albums, because you don't know what you're going to get. Mm-hmm. And that's why I'm very excited for it.
Yeah. Like, for my kind of final thoughts, it's like, I do like this song. And in general, it makes me think this of Kanye. It's like him or not, as Jovi said, he is an innovator. And he'll hit and miss. But no matter what he does, it's like the industry changes every time he puts something out. Every time.
Absolutely, yeah.
That's just the nature of Kanye West.
Well, discography is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.
My mom always said, life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.
You say the worst shit.
Honestly. That line is stupid, too, because you're going to get fucking chocolate.
But you don't know if you're gonna get caramel filled or like the strawberry cream filled.
Oh my god.
Hope you enjoyed watching the video. If you did, leave a like, a comment, subscribe, ring the bell, watch some more of our videos. I appreciate you and I love you.
Definitely let us know how you felt in the comments about this Kanye song in particular.
Show this to your mom.
Don't.
Yeah.
Don't think that anyone feel me. Don't give a fuck if it kill me. Don't think that anyone feel me. Now I'm numb, I can't feel. So I'm lying, it's kill. Baby, show me what's real. Baby, show me what's real.